Good. Welcome, welcome everybody to another episode of the Caribbean Fan Stand. Sorry for the little wait, you know, that's waiting for the stands to fill up a little bit on the outside, a little crowded and, you know, a bit kind of congested, but security limited, so, you know, everybody filter in. Good night to Millie Love. Welcome to the Fan Stand. Sarissa, or Clarissa. Murphy is Clarissa. You know, let me know if I get that right, Clarissa. Season ticket holder, Empress Kells. Welcome to the Fan Stand. Or welcome back. Harvey Vanessa. Good night, Miss Vanessa. I don't know her name, man. I think maybe first time you're in the Fan Stand. Thanks for joining us. Alright. So, for all those who early to the Fan Stand, thank you. For all those that will be joining us later, we appreciate you. Right? And we know some people that say, I know outside crowded, you know, it's a little congested to get inside. But, you know, training is already reach late, so. So, yeah. So, thanks again for joining us on the Fan Stand. Don't forget, after the live, go and follow us on Instagram if you're not following us on Instagram. Follow us on TikTok for various forms of content. All geared to put a smile on your face while keeping you informed. Go to YouTube and subscribe to the Word on the Sheet YouTube page, where you could find pre-recorded episodes of the Fan Stand. So this episode would be uploaded to YouTube at a later date, hopefully a day, 2 days after, if, you know, depending on how the schedule run and the studio availability. Hit the subscribe button on the YouTube page, turn on the bell notification so that when this episode of the Fan Stand and future content drop, you would be informed. Hit up that like button, hit up the subscribe button, as I say. You can check out our latest episode of the Word on the Sheet podcast with myself and Randall, where we discuss the gentleman that was shot in front of Belmont Police Station, the Minister of Family Enterprises, Ms. Donna Cox, and the Commissioner of Police, when their claims that we're in a parenting crisis. You know, you could, and you could share your views on that in the comments under the episode of the podcast. And on that front, on a host of different topics, you can check out the spoiler alert, where we give you, you know, little recommendations of movies and series to watch. So you can check out that. And also, check out Spotify and other major podcasting platforms where you can get audio-only versions of the podcast and the Caribbean Fan Stand. Yeah? So you can check out that. And we have some little surprises, some little, you know, things we're going to be trying to do with the podcast. Hopefully, to make it more, you know, to bring a better product to you, to make it more engaging. A new segment on the way, but we can get into that now, because this tonight is about sports. So, right? So, with all the house cleaning out the way, thanks again for joining myself and the Wooden Shoe team on the Caribbean Fan Stand. Big man, tell us, I wasn't sure if I was going to do anything tonight, because I find in the international breaks, it's be a little boring, because I know that football going on, but some of them international games, I don't want to see England play Moldova, although draw 1-1, but it's more or less an England B team, C team, you know? What the name is? France beat up, what the name is, by Gibraltar, 14-0. I don't see that. I don't know. And if I'm a France fan, probably, yeah, but at the same time, I don't know. I don't talk about that. So I was kind of skeptical, but I see. There are sports going on, so we need to be here. And I'm not in the stadium because though we used to be Trinidad playing America right now. The game is 1-1, but that's not good enough. We need to score. We need to win by 4 goals to go through to the semifinals of the CONCACAF Nations League. And to be honest, I'm not seeing that. That is why I'm not in the stadium. I didn't like the performance of the team on Friday. I didn't like the game plan by Angus. Well, for the most part, three-quarter of the group stage, we were looking good except for the last game. But I didn't like the setup of Angus on Friday. I thought we showed America a little too much respect. Now, yeah, they are the better team, they're the underdogs, but we didn't even look like we know what we're doing us. We even if we play into counter attack. If you're counter attacking, we don't have these players to build from the back. To build through the midfield. Let me be real. And if you're counter attacking, if you're playing all out counter attack, like in the soak up pressure and catch him on the counter, we center, we striker, to be big and strong to hold up the ball. And we didn't have that. PC wingers. So when we get back position, you hit them fast on the wing. You know? We didn't do that. When we was defending good for like 80 minutes, but you know our goal was coming because we defending, but when we get the ball, we just literally giving them right back in our own half because we don't know what we're doing with the ball. So it didn't look like it looked like the team was set up to draw 0-0, and I don't know. That's a big gamble if that was the game plan. And then we come and concede, you know, 3 goals in like 7 minutes or something like that. And that was it, I think, for our chances because I've not seen us scoring 4 goals against America. And even in this game, Angus come and set up with a 5-4-1, 5 defenders in mind. Now, I know he probably go say he could easily convert to a 3 in the back, but at the same time, we got to... It's knockout, it's do or die now, but we just go all out and done. And if we get 10, we get 10, because you can't do nothing after that. But yeah, so to all those who I see we score a second goal there, so but that's said enough. We gotta beat them by 4 goals, so we gotta score 5 goals in this game to win an aggregate. Yeah, okay, senior. I didn't watch the game on Friday, but most of my brethren make. Red Rams for the setup with Angus, so yeah, that was telling everybody we didn't look like we know what we was doing, and if that what Angus wanted to do, we'll see it. So, and I think we put ourselves in a bad position. In a bad position to come home to play. You know, if we did lose at 1-0, maybe at 2-0, instead of lost by 1 goal or 2 goals to the most, you'd have a fighting chance. But now, 4 goals, we had to win by not score. We had to win by 4 goals to go to an aggregate. And them don't score, so we had to score 4-5 tonight. I ain't that confident, sorry. Sorry, Soka Warriors fans. So, but I know, you know, we shouldn't even keep your hopes up. And win, lose, or draw, everybody by fits or by 63 on the avenue, something, you know? So, yeah. In other football news, in the Euro qualifying, let me see who qualified for the Euros thus far. I think most of the group setup is just the playoffs to go through now. I could be wrong, or they correct me if I'm wrong. I'll big up my brother Law Banton in the fan stand, season ticket holder. You know, I think he just be up in the suite. He have a suite, he don't really be. Thing you go, you know, you go up in the suite and rock back and thing, but they got my brother Law Banton always on the inside and the live with us. So Germany is the host, so they inside all that Germany. That is, you know, three in international football. Every Trinidad have a different team. We do just back we Trinidad alone because I mean, it's only one World Cup you ever went to. We can't brag about that much. Most of Trinidad is Brazilians. In the last decade or so, some Spaniards arise. There's some Argentines. I know it have a good bit of Italians as well, but I am always like Germany from since I'm small. I don't know. I just find Germany that order about them, but in the last decade, 15 years, they kind of get a little more technical and a little more flary players. But I just find there was either was disciplined in how they display. So that was really kind of gravity to them, you know, like, you know where you're going to get in, you know, and in football history, international football history. In recent time, I know Italy, they'll fall off a little, and Germany falling off a little bit, but not as bad as Italy, but, you know, when it comes to tournament time, you can't count on the Germans, neither the Italians, and that was kind of, you know, like, you know, the kind of, I like the discipline in them. So, when it comes to international football, I support Germany. We're under some pressure in the last 6 years or so, since the last World Cup win in 2014. And I put that down to plenty of people jumping on the bandwagon, because in 2018, when we come out in the group stage, well, I think it's back to back World Cup in the group stage, the amount of German fans I see that I never knew before, I say, way boy, Trini's love our wagon, boy. Hey, yeah, so I put that on to the bandwagon and send them. They're heavy in me down. So, hopefully with the couple of bad years we have in, the jump over the bandwagon, jump on Argentina or some kind of thing. And we catch back myself. Speaking of which, we lost in a friendly to Turkey, I believe, over the weekend. Yeah. So, like, and we named the fire hands effect they bring in. Right, my name is. Was coaching Bayern the other day, and I ain't really seen much difference in the team. I don't know. I think Germany has some good players, but in the most important, some important positions, they're lacking certain players. But yeah, Nagelsmann, yeah, Julian Nagelsmann is a new coach, and interim. I think he only take a deal up to the end of the Euros, probably to, you know, to boost up his career, since he's firing from Bayern, and then he didn't take the, I think he turned on the PSG job and the Chelsea job, if rumors are true. But I didn't really want him for the Chelsea job, but that's what I will say. So anyhow, back to the reports. So Germany, the host, they are inside the Euro 2024. Spain win Group A, they are inside. Scotland inside, they come second in group A. I like in Scotland, you know, I didn't think they could win anything, but I like in the little resurgence in the last year or so. France win Group B, they inside. Netherlands come second in Group B, they also inside. England, no surprise. England is always... And that is why England have good players, and have probably, man for man, England must be the best team going heading into the Euros. I know France is supposed to be the favourites, but one is the politics, and two, England's qualifying has always been deceiving. Because it's always get easy groups, walk through the groups. And the media and the English fans just get wild and say, yeah, we're going to beat people. Because, you know, we're going to defeated in qualifying. But when you play North Macedonia and Malta and thing, yo, you're supposed to be undefeated. So, although man for man still, and the top players win, like Rich James, the best right back in the world, injured. So, and he didn't really play in some months for them. Still in the fight, you know, still in a little bit of the scene. Luke Shaw and Ben Chilwell injured as well. I think Luke Shaw is more of a shoe-in for the left back than Ben Chilwell, but Luke Shaw injured as well. So there are some players who will even make the team stronger coming closer to the Euros. But yeah, England inside, they win Group C. Where is Italy? Controversial. I didn't see the game. I was watching some news before I come on live. I think Ukraine got a penalty late. My boy Modric went a penalty and VAR fuck it up. Normal thing with VAR. So Italy, they end up on the same points, but I think in Euros it's be head to head. In UEFA it be head to head, so that they probably had a better head to head than Ukraine. So Ukraine going into the playoffs, and Italy, the defending champions, thankfully they inside, because they missed two World Cups consecutive. So they decided to defend the Euros title. Turkey. The inside as well. They win Group D. Trying to figure out what's going on here. Yeah, so Turkey inside. Albania as well. They win Group E. Well, I guess in Group D. So Turkey will finish top two in Group D. So Group D not fully decided. I think Croatia, Wales. I ain't sure who is the next team. Oh, probably Germany, I ain't sure, but yeah. So Turkey inside for sure. The next people that they could finish, either one or two. Albania, as I said, win Group E. Czech Republic. The runners up in Group E, so them inside as well. Belgium win Group F. Austria come second in Group F. Hungary inside as well, they won Group G. Serbia runners up in Group G, they're also inside. Denmark win Group H. I think Hoyland playing for them, for the Manchester United fans. Slovenia inside as well, they come second in Group H. Romania in Group I, the top two similar to Turkey. So they inside, that's, I don't know if they're finishing first or second. Switzerland as well, same thing. So is Switzerland and Romania inside? That's who finishing on top of the group is left to be decided. Portugal with Ronaldo, they won Group G. Slovakia runners up in Group G. So that is the qualifiers for the Euros thus far, coming off next year, 2024 in Germany. Princess Nessia, welcome to the fan stand. Wondan, also inside on the fan stand, thanks for being here with us. Season pass is still available. MK Promotions inside the fan stand, big up the MK Promotions. MK link we have, we could do some sponsors to the podcast, Wooden Street Podcast. We see that reasonable prices, you know, that's to build the show and you know, broaden the reach of the MK Promotions team. Ask DJ Marlon about Wood, ask him about Tower, and you let him know his scene. So big up MK Promotions on the fan inside on the fan stand. Right, so we then deal with the Euros. We did with Trinidad, still the score is still 2-1 in the 68th minute. We need to score 5 goals to go through into the semi-finals. I don't think it's possible, but fingers crossed. In the NBA, so a little wrap up in the NBA, we're going through the games as usual. But we will just see who top in the conferences, and now we will go into the in-season tournament a little bit. So Boston Celtics back on top in the Eastern Conference. Philadelphia 76ers dropped to second. Milwaukee Bucks third. The Miami Heat fourth currently. Orlando Magic fifth. Sixth is the New York Knicks. Alright, and that is the top spots. You know, the next set are, that is the people who in guaranteed playoff spots right now. 7 to 10 is the play-in, but we ain't getting down to the nitty-gritty of the play-in yet. So that's the top 6 in the East, in the West, and in the NBA. All you know, Golden State is my team. For all the people who been to the fan stand already, right now we under pressure. We start off the season good. Right now we on a 6-game losing streak. Last season, we could not win a game home. I'm on the road. Now we can't win a game home. Pressure. And our last game, that last defeat in overtime against OKC was heartbreaking. Yeah, but anyway, can't be talking about a losing team so much. Unless it's Chelsea. Well, Chelsea losing, but that's it. Minnesota. Wow, I didn't even know that. Minnesota, this is surprising. I didn't even know this. Minnesota Timberwolves on top of the West currently. OKC, the Oklahoma City Thunder second. Denver Nuggets drop down to third. Fourth is the Sacramento Kings. Fifth, the Dallas Mavericks. And sixth, the Los Angeles Lakers. Right now, LeBron Tottenham. Serious. Yeah? So that is how the East and the West looking now. And the NBA, we're going to the playing tournament right now. Big up Aiden and Kaden, mommy, inside in the fan stand. Good night. Hope it won't be the last. Right, every Monday at 9 p.m. we're here in the Caribbean fan stand where we discuss everything sports. Share your views on everything sports, Rabs, your rivals. Once it's sports related and we don't go too much over the top, everything is welcome. All is fair in love and sports. So yeah, in the playing tournament, in Group A, Philadelphia second, Indiana Pacers, first, both teams played two games each. In Group B, same thing, both teams played two games, Milwaukee Bucks and Miami. When I say play, they play at 1-2 and win 2, eh? Yeah, so Group C, still in the East. Group C in the East. Boston Celtics first, Brooklyn Nets second, and each group have five teams, but we're going through all five. Let's talk about who in the lead for now. Group A in the West, Los Angeles Lakers, they play 3-1-3, so they're looking good in the season. Utah Jazz second with a 2-1 record. Let's now go back up to the East. So Detroit and Group A, they eliminated from the knockout stage because they 0-3. I think it's five games everybody playing. Wizards also in Group B, 0-3, so they out. So you're going back to the West now. Memphis out in Group A, they also lost 3. So given the fact that if you lost 3, you're out. That is the benchmark. Depending on if you lost 3, out for sure. So I go B in the West. New Orleans Pelicans 2-1, they first. Denver Nuggets 2-1, second. Group C, the Kings 2-0, and the Minnesota Timberwolves 2-0. The San Antonio Spurs, they out with 3 losses as well. Yeah, so that's how the in-season tournament going. That's if you don't know, that new little kind of, I want to say a knockout tournament because a group stage into a knockout, but a little tournament, the NBA thing, you know, to spice it up. To make the kind of middle of the season, not so much middle, but you know, like they say mid, but it's not mid season, but some of the games that was taken less serious historically in the past, so they bring out the in season tournament to give a little more spice to these games. So games running between, I believe, October and December. Or October and the end of November, at most really December, yeah. That so for the semifinals and the finals are going to Las Vegas. Me personally, I'll talk Golden State as my team, Steph Curry the player. If not Warriors, I would like to see a small team in terms of somebody who never win an NBA title ever or in a while, a long while. And I mean like Celtics who win since 2009. I mean like somebody who wants to have one in the history and name in 20 years. I know who that might be. Or a young team like a OKC or somebody to win it. You know, just to get a little more meaning to the season that one. They might win the title, you know, the NBA championship, but you know, he has some silverware to think. So I believe, and the commissioner Adam Silver mentioned it, they're trying to take a little page out of the European football setup, you know, besides the league tournament, the league title, where the smaller teams might, you know, add the longevity to win, they could win a FA Cup or a League Cup or something like that. Yeah, so. I like the course. I don't know what you think about the in-season tournament course, but I like the course though. I know some people didn't really like it, but I like the. I like how just for the in-season, you know, a little color and thing. Some of them, some nicer than some. I find Golden State course is shit. The best one I see that I can remember, Chicago Bulls court real nice. Atlanta court real nice. And Atlanta catch me because I don't normally play in blue, so the court is like kind of. Sky blue mixes a dark blue, so it looking nice. I like them thing. Let me know what you think about the in-season tournament courts. Any comments? Yeah, and before we go, that's on the cricket front, Australia the sixth time World Cup winners. That's the 50 overs. Excuse me, so big up Australia and all the Australian fans on here. That team is a boogie. What I mean is that come like I was saying, the football with Germany and Italy historically, you can't count them out. After about four games, I didn't follow it like religiously, but I just kind of keeping up with, you know, what going on with it. After about four games, Australia was turtle last. Because it was one big group, it didn't have different groups, everybody was playing like a round robin. And a man telling me this, he's a cricket man. Sunil, big up yourself, Sunil. Sunil say, well, those are the way Australia is, don't count them out. Well, once they make it to the knockout stage, they're going to win it. That's how they do this thing. And just like I mean, I want to watch more football, but good teams know when to pick. They don't pick too early in tournament play. And boy, it's so sad to learn England come on, they beat us India in the final. Now, I don't really like any of them, but if I had to pick one, I'd rather Australia win it because somehow I just don't like Kohli and I don't like. Now, I big up to them, but you see how Australia doesn't let the players play in any of the T20 tournaments, but that is what the best of the best to come and play by them. And I know them is like the marquee T20 tournament. I find that nice shippiness. So I find I feel like they're better than everybody when it comes to cricket right now. Even Kohli, I think Kohli apologized when he said, yeah, you know, he had that kind of image, but yeah. So big up Australia, six-time World Cup winners. The T20 World Cup will be held in the West Indies next year. So all you organize all yourself, save up all your money. There we go. You know, if it's T20 itself, if nothing else, test match, definitely not. 50 overs, maybe. But definitely, I think we could have a competitive team, the West Indies guys, for the T20 tournament. And we're the host, so we would be present, unlike the 50 overs where we was absent. So yeah, let's save up all the money. I know the dates and thing as yet. I didn't really research. I just know it's been held down here. Probably at a later date, coming closer, I will... Or if only remind me, you know, if I put any comments and just remind me. Or the DM or something. On wood on the street and I will get the dates and the venues and things. So probably if not in other islands, when they're playing in Trinidad, we can hopefully we get some games in Trinidad because you know there's be a little bias with it. But we are the most vibes, so that I feel like come here, definitely. You know, so we go out and support the team. So yeah, next year 2024 the T20 World Cup will be held in the West Indies. Yeah, so I feel that is it for the fans and for the tonight. Still 2-1. Currently 78 minutes going in the game. Gotta score 3 more goals unanswered to qualify for the semifinals in the Nations League. So we'll see how that goes. Yeah. So yeah, people, thanks for joining me and the Wood and the Shit team. For the Caribbean fan stand, don't forget for the people who are here for the first time, we here every Monday from 9 p.m. Wooden Shoot. If you haven't already after the live. Follow us on Instagram. Follow us on, go check out on TikTok. For different forms of content. You know, I try not to be monotonous. We try not to be monotonous in the content across different platforms. You know, just so if you see one thing on one platform, you can go on the next platform and see it. So, you know, so we try to have, you know, content kind of geared to different platforms to, you know, to capture the audiences. So follow us on Instagram, follow us on TikTok, for various types of content, and all you know what we are about. We just about, you know, sharing information, keeping you informed, but also keeping a smile on your face. We don't want to be, you know, we don't promote our vibes and kill joy vibes and thing, right? So all that is what Wood on the Street is about. Just keeping you informed while putting a smile on your face. So follow us on Instagram, follow us on TikTok, check out the content. Go to YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube page, Wood on the Street. You can check out our latest episode of the podcast where we discuss the brazen shootings, for example. You know, the guy that was shot in front of the Belmont police station some days ago, I believe he is now deceased, Bumbles. We also touch on the Minister of Social Development and Family Enterprises, Ms. Donna Cox, saying that we have a parenting crisis coming out of the shooting in the double murder in Arouca, where the 15-year-old and 18-year-old were gunned down, and she said we have a parenting crisis. I personally disagree, because I know if I have parents out there trying the very best, the utmost best. So like, check out that, share your views on those comments. Also we also discussed this, the Miss Lisa Aga, the CEO of TSTT, who departed the company. Yeah. And the spoiler alert, you know, where we get recommendations for little movies and series to watch. So you go and check out the latest episode of the podcast, Wood on the Street. Also, you can get audio-only versions of the podcast and the Caribbean Fan Stand on Spotify and other major podcasting platforms. Nice? So, until next time, until next week, Monday, Godspeed Live, for another episode of the Caribbean Fan Stand, when the domestic leagues would be back. My name is Tawa, aka Wood. Keep your ears on the ground, and we go get the word out.
Ghost Gang Entertainment.